Pushing the boundaries of sexual politics, pop music, and of course, black eyeliner, singer Adam Lambert has wasted no time in grabbing North America by the leash with the release of his debut album, For Your Entertainment. The American Idol contestant turned solo artist made headlines last year after raising a few eyebrows with a titillating tongue-in-cheek performance at the American Music Awards, and it was not long after that Barbara Walters listed Lambert as one of 2009's most fascinating people. Unashamed and untarnished, the charming pop star sat down with Xtra at Parlour Salon in Toronto to talk about his music and where he stands in 2010. It's 2010 now.
It is.
And looking back on 2009 and looking at all the stories that were written about you, what's your critique? Do you think the media was fair? Do you think you were portrayed accurately?
For the most part, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I think certain things are sensationalized. I think certain things need to be sensationalized a little bit because there's a lack of them in the media. I mean, I think being like an out, mainstream, visible artist in the music industry isn't very common these days. So, of course, the media is going to sensationalize it and kind of talk about it a lot because I think many members of the media are gay and are excited.
Yeah.
That there's somebody that they can talk about. I think if there's any drawback to that is sometimes that overshadows the fact that I'm a singer and a musician and that's what I do.
Right.
You know, sometimes it's like openly gay singer, Adam Lambert, yada, yada, yada. And I'm like, guys, the openly gay part is like should be like a sidebar. I mean, that's my personal life. That doesn't define who I am. And then with everything that happened with certain performances and certain award shows, because of some of my decisions, it did become, you know, kind of in your face and overt. And, you know, in the long run, I think it's a good thing. I think we don't have a lot of that.
What did you think about when some of the gay organizations in the States piped up and they said, oh, you know, his performance is, you know, going to ruin the same-sex marriage movement, or it's going to give us a bad name. Like, what do you think of that?
It's interesting. I guess I understand what they're talking about, but I think that there's it's kind of old-fashioned. I think there's a generational divide a little bit. I think it's like what I'm talking about. I think that we need to show the diversity that is a gay person, and there are some gay people that are really conservative and kind of straight-laced and. Don't like to see things that are overt and in your face, you know, just like straight people. I mean, I just, there's not one type of gay person. For example, in media, you know, we were dealing for a long time in the past with race relations in our world. And there were two different types of like black people on TV, for example. Right. And now we're colorblind to it,
which
is beautiful.
Yeah.
We need to become that way about sexuality. That should be our goal. But now, here we are. So what do you want from me? What do you want from me? In 2010, as we move forward, as we integrate and we become less of a gay community, straight community, I think that the next goal is to become a human community and to stop segregating. And in the media, I think the thing that needs to happen is that there needs to show the diversity that is a gay man and a gay woman, is that there are many different types of gay people, just like there are many different types of straight people.
Listen, I could talk about gay politics with you all day, but you know what? You're a musician. So let's talk about the music for once.
I love it.
What's on your playlist right now? What are you listening to?
Gaga, of course.
Okay, good.
You know, who's not? she's amazing. Beyonce, of course.
Yeah.
You know, the divas, you know.
The divas.
All the divas are in there. You know, Madonna, Christina. They're all in there. Even a little Britney, even though the singing part is a little computerized. I still enjoy the music.
Well, you worked with Gaga and Pink on your album.
I did. And Pink, oh, God, I love Pink. I saw her concert and she was on fire. She's such a rock star. I love it.
If you were to cover a Lady Gaga song, which song would you cover?
It would probably have to be Speechless.
Yeah.
I just think it's so classic. It's so that like Elton John kind of like piano 70s rock Carole King type ballad, and it's driving and it's great, and her voice sounds great on it. The lyrics are fantastic. The melody is unbelievable. I would love to sing that. Working with her in the studio was like such a treat.
Oh, I can imagine.
And the song that she contributed, Fever, on the album is like one of my favorite tracks on the album. I think it's so much fun. Probably one of the most fun to do live.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Talking about your album, an amazing album.
Thank you.
I listen to it at the gym all the time.
Thank you.
It's a good gym album.
Right? There's a couple little like really slow aggressive ones in there, but there's some pumping.
We listen to the slow ones between reps, you know, just to calm
cool
down.
Off. Cool off.
Yeah, it's a cool off song.
Yeah, the slow ones are for the Pilates.
The Pilates. What song on this album is the most personal to you?
Probably Broken Open. Mm-hmm. That was a song that I wrote with Greg Wells and Evan Bogart. And it's basically dealing with helping somebody be vulnerable enough to just cry, just to fall apart. And it's a very, very personal thing. And there was a period in my life where it just kept repeating itself. I would meet people, either they would be close friends and this would happen to, but more often it was people that I kind of would have chance encounters with, whether it would be a lover or just a friend that I would meet that I didn't know that well. And oftentimes alcohol was involved. It was like after a club or something, and people would come over to the house, you know, like kick it afterwards, and it was like a one night stand in there. There was a friend that I just happened to have made that night, like someone that had been an acquaintance for years, and I was like, what are you doing? Come back and like hang out. And it wasn't even a hookup thing. It was like just a new friend. And one or two or three or four or five or six of these people, like over the course of a couple months, were choosing me to just break open to. It just kept happening, and I was like, wow, what am I a therapist? What's going on here? Like, why, what is it that I'm giving them that allows them to feel that way? And it meant a lot to me, because it meant that I was making someone feel safe, and I was making somebody feel like they could be imperfect with me. And I think that's what the song's about. That's what I wrote about. So imperfectly what you should be. Lay you safe, you let you
be broken open. What do you think of the music industry right now? You know, you're tired of this artist that came out queer right at the beginning. Mm-hmm. You weren't caught, you know, blowing some guy in a bathroom. You weren't caught in a park. You know, you didn't have a career, then come out after.
Yeah, homo don't play that. Homo don't play.
Yeah. No. You've just sort of been, you know, queer from the start. Yeah. Do you think we're going to see any Adam Lambert knockoffs this year?
I hope so. That'd be cool. Yeah, that'd be really cool. It'd be flattering. Yeah. It would be nice to see more visibility. I think that's the big step.
Let's talk about your voice. How high can you sing?
Sort of high.
What's the highest note you've ever hit?
I don't know. I'm not that singer that, and I actually hate these kind of singers. It was like, that was a B. You know, I'm like... Yeah, I roll my eyes at people like that. I'm like, it doesn't matter what note it was. Did it sound cool? You know what I mean? I'm not technical like that these days.
You're not like one of the characters on Glee, where you see how high you can sing.
Yeah, it's not my MO, you know? And like, I came from a world where that kind of was the mentality. Okay. You know, taking voice lessons, being in theater, and being like, well, they hit the high E, so, you know, they're right here. You know, I just,
exactly.
I don't think that's really feeling music. I don't think that's real like rock and roll style. Like, exactly. I think you just sing.
I was wondering if you could give your fans a little teaser and sing us something a cappella.
No, it's not happening.
No, it's not happening.
You have to buy the CD.
Oh,
I got 2 hours of
admission.
I got 2 hours of sleep, yo. I'm like, ah.
He's like, pay up. Well, that's okay. It'll give us something to look forward to.
Put me on the spot like that. You owe me a drink.
I owe him a drink. Let's go. I want a Woody's.
I've been there. I like that place.
Thank you so much, Adam.
Thank you. Hi there. I'm Adam Lambert, and you're watching Xtra.ca.